Want to speak real Portuguese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at PortuguesePod101.com.
Hi everyone, Paloma here. Welcome to Top 25 Portuguese Phrases. Oi, hi. Oi is a very common phrase in Brazil because when you meet someone, you want to greet him or her, you just say oi to everyone. You can also use olá, that is very common, but oi is more common than olá. Oi, gente! Hi, everyone! Tudo bem? How are you? Tudo bem is a very useful phrase because it means a lot of things. It could be tudo bem? How are you? Or tudo bem? I'm fine. Or tudo bem? It's okay. So, whenever in any situation, you can use tudo bem. Tudo bem comigo. Everything's fine with me. Que legal! That's nice. Que legal is also very useful because when you want to say that something is cool or something's nice or that you're excited about something, you just say que legal. So, que legal que você está aprendendo português. That's nice that you're learning Portuguese. Bom dia. Good morning. Bom dia is the way you greet people in the morning. To be a little more formal, instead of oi or olá, you can use bom dia. So, bom dia, tudo bom com a senhora? Good morning, how are you, madam? Boa tarde. Good afternoon. Boa tarde is the way you greet people afternoon until 5 or 6 p.m., until dawn. So you could say, espero que você tenha uma boa tarde. I hope you have a good afternoon. Boa noite. Good evening. Boa noite is the way you greet people at night. So you can say good evening. Boa noite to someone on the street, but you can also say boa noite, good night to someone at home. Boa noite, mãe. Eu vou dormir. Good night, mom. I'm going to sleep. Prazer. Nice to meet you. Prazer is a nice phrase because it's actually a word, so it's very short. You can use more complex phrases like prazer em conhecê-lo or é prazer, but prazer is enough. Tchau. Bye. Tchau is the way you say bye to someone in Portuguese. So you can say tchau or tchau tchau, and that would be fine. So, eu vou dar tchau para minha amiga. I'm going to say bye to my friend. Estou bem, e você? I'm fine, and you? Estou bem means I'm fine. So, if you're not fine, you can say estou mal, or não estou bem, I'm not fine. Como você está, or tudo bem? You can say estou bem. Por favor, please. Por favor is a very polite phrase that you need to know when you go to Brazil. So, if you want to ask someone to bring you some water, you can say, por favor, você pode me trazer pouco de água? Please, can you bring me some water? Obrigado. Obrigada. Thank you. Obrigado is super important because you need to thank people when you ask something. So, obrigado is how men would say it and obrigada is how women say it. So, obrigada por assistir ao nosso vídeo. Thank you for watching our video. De nada. You're welcome. And de nada is the opposite now. So, when someone tells you obrigada, you can say de nada. De nada. É prazer. You're welcome. It's a pleasure. Sim. Yes. So, if someone asks you, do you want to learn Portuguese? You can just say sim. Yes. Sim, eu quero aprender português. Yes, I want to learn Portuguese. Não, no. So, não has a very unique sound in Portuguese because it's a nasal sound. Não. Tudo bem. Okay. So, as I said before, tudo bem is very useful. You can say tudo bem to maybe everything in Brazil. Você não quer sair? Tudo bem. You don't want to go out? That's okay. Com licença. Excuse me. When you bump to someone on the street or you want to pass through someone, you can say com licença or da licença. Da licença, posso passar? Excuse me, can I pass through? Desculpa, I'm sorry. Desculpa, não foi a minha intenção. I'm sorry, that wasn't my intention. When you hurt someone or when you bump into someone on the street or when you want to apologize to someone, you just say desculpa. Que horas são? What time is it? If you want to ask someone that you don't know, what time is it? You can say, com licença, senhor. Que horas são? Excuse me, sir. What time is it? Onde fica o location? Where is the location? If you really need to go to the restroom and you don't know where it is, you can say, onde fica o banheiro? Where's the restroom? Or if you want to find a beautiful beach that you heard about, you can say, onde fica a praia? Where's the beach? O meu nome é? My name is? This one is very easy and useful. So, o meu nome é Paloma. My name is Paloma. Qual o seu nome? What's your name? Por quê? Why? If you want to ask someone, por que você chegou atrasado? Why were you late? Or if you want to complain with your boyfriend, say, por que você não me ligou? Why didn't you call me? Se cuida. Take care. Usually when we say goodbye to people, we also say se cuida. Take care. So, tchau amigo, se cuida. Bye my friend, take care. Quanto que fica? How much is it? So if you're shopping in Brazil and you buy a lot of stuff, you can just ask, quanto que fica? How much is it for the total of things you're buying? But if you want to ask just the price of a shirt, you can say, quanto custa esta camiseta? How much is this shirt? Yeah, that's a very useful phrase if you want to buy something in Brazil. Até mais. See you soon. Até mais is another way to say bye to someone. So you can say, yeah, we have trains and helicopters around. Até mais is the way to say bye to someone, and it actually means until more, but you can say just até mais or até amanhã, see you tomorrow, até mais tarde, see you later. So, até mais. Vamos embora. Let's go. Okay, so my final phrase is vamos embora, let's go or let's leave. You can also say vamos embora or vambora, that is the fastest way to say it. We use it, for example, if a party is too boring and you can say que festa chata, vamos embora. What a boring party, let's leave. Or vambora, eu quero ir pra lá. Let's go, I wanna go there. O vídeo está acabando, então vamos embora. The video is ending then, let's leave. See you. Tchau, tchau. Obrigada. Welcome to PortuguesePod101.com, Português em 3 minutos. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Brazilian Portuguese. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer. Hi, I'm Paloma. Nice to meet you. In this series, we are going to learn basic Portuguese expressions. It's super easy and it takes only 3 minutes. It also takes only 3 sentences. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to introduce yourself in Portuguese. It may vary a little depending on the person you're talking to. Let's first take a look at the most common way. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-lo. Hi, I'm Paloma. It's a pleasure to meet you. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-lo. Start by saying, oi, meu nome é. Then say your name. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Finally, say, prazer em conhecê-lo. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-lo. Please pay attention to the end of the sentence. This version is only used if you're introducing yourself to a man, because you say, conhecê-lo. If you're introducing yourself to a woman, you should use conhecê-la. So the full sentence to introduce yourself to a woman would be, oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-la. Here's a quick tip to help you if you don't remember which article to use in the end of the sentence. Just use prazer. Prazer. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer. Let's check what you've learned. Based on who I'm talking to, try to remember how to introduce yourself. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-la. Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Prazer em conhecê-lo. When introducing yourself in Brazil, it's polite to shake hands. This is used in formal situations. In a more informal situation, people may kiss you on the cheek. The number of kisses may vary from person to person or region. Some people only kiss once, but others may kiss you 2 or even 3 times. Now it's time for Paloma's point. If you're introducing yourself to a group, you should say either conhecê-los or conhecê-las. If the group is all men or a mix of men and women, say conhecê-los. If the group is woman only, use conhecê-las. Do you know how to say thank you in Portuguese? You'll learn how to say this and many other words in the next lesson. Tchau, tchau! See you then!
Oi, gente! Tudo bem? This is Jade Furuta and welcome to Portuguese Weekly Words. Today's theme is currency exchange. This is important. Câmbio, foreign exchange. Eu estou procurando uma agência de câmbio. Eu estou procurando uma agência de câmbio. I'm looking for a foreign exchange office. Converter. To convert. Converter. To convert. Well, I travel a lot and I also work for people from all over the world because I am an interpreter. And a lot of times they ask me to pay me in a different currency or they don't know how to convert their money. And I always can do it real quick. Yay! Eu sou boa em converter dinheiro. I'm good at converting currencies. Dólar americano. Dólar americano. US dollar. Eu trouxe um pouco de dólar americano. Eu trouxe um pouco de dólar americano. I brought some US dollars. It's really good to always have a little bit of foreign currency with you. Like a strong one, euro or especially dollar. I always travel carrying a little bit of dollar with me. Moeda, coin. Moeda, coin. Eu estou com muitas moedas no bolso. Eu estou com muitas moedas no bolso. I have many coins in my pocket. Taxa de câmbio. Taxa de câmbio. Exchange rate. A taxa de câmbio é muito alta. A taxa de câmbio é muito alta. The exchange rate is too high. Acabou! Thank you for watching. Você está aprendendo? Are you learning? Have a good weekend and see you next week. Um beijo! Tchau!
Hi guys, Paloma here. Welcome to Top 10 Lines You Need to Introduce Yourself in Portuguese. Estou aprendendo português com a PortuguesePod101.com. I'm learning Portuguese at PortuguesePod101.com. If someone asks you, how are you learning Portuguese? Como você está estudando português? You can say, eu estou estudando com a PortuguesePod101.com. Estou aprendendo português faz ano. I've been learning Portuguese for a year. This is the answer to the question, faz quanto tempo que você estuda português? How long have you been studying Portuguese? Eu gosto de ouvir música. I enjoy listening to music. So, if someone asks you, o que você gosta de fazer? What do you enjoy or what do you like to do? You can say, eu gosto de ouvir música. Eu moro em São Paulo. I live in São Paulo. This is the answer to the question, onde você mora? Where do you live? You could answer saying the country you live or the city you live. If it's very famous, for example, eu moro em Tóquio, I live in Tokyo, or eu moro em Nova York, I live in New York. Eu sou do Brasil, I'm from Brazil. If someone asks you, de onde você é, where are you from? You can say, eu sou do Brasil, or eu sou brasileira, I'm Brazilian. Eu sou professor, I'm a teacher. Here you are saying your job, so you could say, eu sou professor, I'm a teacher, or eu sou estudante, I'm a student. Eu tenho 27 anos. I'm 27 years old. People may ask your age, so you answer with the verb ter, to have, in Portuguese. Eu tenho 27 anos. I am 27 years old. O meu nome é Miguel. My name is Miguel. This phrase works both for woman or man, so I could say o meu nome é Paloma, as a man could say o meu nome é Miguel. Oi, prazer. Hi, nice to meet you. Oi, prazer. This is a way to introduce yourself very casually. So you can just shake hands with the person and say, oi, prazer, or just give her a kiss. You could also say, oi, meu nome é Paloma, prazer. Dos meus hobbies é ler. One of my hobbies is reading. Usually when you're meeting someone new, they may ask you, what's your hobby? You could say, um dos meus hobbies é ler, or um dos meus hobbies é ver filmes. One of my hobbies is watching movies, or even um dos meus hobbies é viajar. One of my hobbies is traveling. Okay, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed our video, and don't forget to subscribe to our website and our YouTube channel. See you next time. Tchau, tchau.
Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Hi, everybody. I'm Paloma. Welcome to PortuguesePod101.com's Português em 3 Minutos, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Portuguese. In the last lesson, we learned the most common forms of greetings in Portuguese. Do you remember them? In this lesson, we are going to learn a very useful phrase. Do you speak English? If you find yourself in a situation where you need assistance in English, this phrase can be a lifesaver. And because you're asking it in Portuguese, you can be sure that everyone will understand what you're saying, even if their answer is no. Here's the informal way to say it. Você fala inglês? Você fala inglês? In Portuguese, verbs change depending on the pronoun that is used. Please notice the word você in the beginning of the sentence. This is the informal way to say you. The next word is the verb falar, which means to speak. Because it's referring to você, it is conjugated to você fala. And you probably recognize inglês to be English. Você fala inglês? To learn how to properly conjugate verbs in Portuguese, like falar, please look at our beginner series on PortuguesePod101.com. You can find very detailed grammar lessons and resources there. If you're talking with young people or someone the same age as you, you can add a small word to sound more natural. Moço, meaning boy, and moça, girl. It is common to address the people around you like this. Moço, moço. Moça, moça. Moço, você fala inglês? Moça, você fala inglês? Now, we'll see how to talk with a person older than you. It is very easy. You just need to change você into o senhor or a senhora. That means sir and madam in English. Everything else stays the same. O senhor fala inglês? O senhor fala inglês? A senhora fala inglês? A senhora fala inglês? Adding com licença, excuse me, the sentence becomes more polite. Com licença, moço, você fala inglês? Com licença, moço, você fala inglês? Or, com licença, o senhor fala inglês? Com licença, o senhor fala inglês? The responses you receive could be one of these three. Sim, yes. Sim, um pouco, a little. Um pouco. Não, eu não falo inglês. No, I don't speak English. Não, eu não falo inglês. Since this last one is a negative statement, we need to say não before the verb falar. It is conjugated in the first person, eu falo. So, I don't speak is eu não falo. Now it's time for Paloma's point. For those of you who are not only English speakers, you can obviously use this question with any other language you need. Some people in Brazil study other languages at school, so maybe you get lucky. Just substitute English with italiano for Italian, russo for Russian, espanhol for Spanish, alemão for German, or any other language. In this lesson, we mentioned the expression com licença. But did you know that this could also be used as an apology? In the next lesson, we'll learn this and other ways to apologize in Portuguese. It's never too late to show your good manners with Brazilian people. I'll see you in our next Português em 3 Minutos lesson. Até mais!
Bom dia, gente! Tudo bom? Paloma here. Welcome to Top Portuguese Words. Today's topic is how to respond to how are you?
Tudo bem? How are you?
Tudo bem? How are you?
I think you already know that tudo bem can be the question and also the answer.
Tudo bem?
Tudo bem.
Oi, tudo bem?
Tudo bem.
E você?
E aí, beleza?
Hey, what's up?
E aí, beleza?
Hey, what's up?
Beleza means beauty, but in this case, I think it means more like everything's beautiful with you. You can also answer beleza. This is very casual, so it's best to avoid it in a more formal or business situation. E você? And you? E você? And you? Of course, if someone asks you, e aí, beleza? Or tudo bem? It's common courtesy to also ask them, e você? And you? Tudo ótimo. Everything is great. Tudo ótimo. Everything is great. If you don't want to answer the same way as the question, tudo bem? Tudo bem. You can also say, tudo ótimo. Everything is great. Eu estou bem. I'm fine. Eu estou bem. I'm fine. That's another option. Bem means well in Portuguese or fine. Eu estou bem. Eu estou bem também. I'm fine too. Eu estou bem também. I'm fine too. So if you say, eu estou bem, e você? The person can answer, eu estou bem também. I'm also fine. Então tá bom. Then it's all good. It's very common to say after all these steps, então tá bom. Then it's all good. Oi, tudo bom? Tudo bem, e você? Tudo bem. Ah, então tá bom. Eu estou me sentindo mal. I'm feeling bad. Tudo bem? Não, tô me sentindo mal. No, I'm feeling bad. Maybe I ate something that wasn't good. Eu estou ótima. I'm great. Oi, tudo bom? Como você tá? How are you? Eu estou ótima. I'm great. Obrigada por perguntar. Thank you for asking. If you want to be very polite, you can say obrigada por perguntar or obrigado por perguntar. Thank you for asking. The end. That's it for today. Tudo bem com você? How are you? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time. Bye bye.
Welcome to PortuguesePod101.com's Português em 3 Minutos, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Brazilian Portuguese. In the last lesson, we learned how to thank people by saying muito obrigado and how to reply with de nada. Today, we'll learn some common ways to say hello and goodbye in Brazil. Vocês estão prontos? Are you ready? Then, let's start! The most common informal greeting is oi! Oi! Oi means hello. We say it when we meet someone. You may also say olá. That also means hello. Olá! Another common greeting that you hear a lot in Brazil and at PortuguesePod101.com is tudo bem. Tudo bem? Tudo bem means is everything fine? We use it usually together with oi or olá to greet someone. Altogether, you can say oi, tudo bem? Oi, tudo bem? Tudo bem is a question, but it can also be the answer. Just say tudo bem, which means everything is fine. At the end, you can add e você? And you? Tudo bem, e você? Tudo bem, e você? When it's time to leave, we have a couple of different ways to say goodbye. You may say tchau. Tchau means bye. Tchau. You can also say see you soon. Até mais. Até mais. You also have adeus, which means goodbye. But you usually use it when the person is leaving to somewhere far or you're not going to meet for some time. Adeus. You learned a lot of new phrases today. Let's review with a quiz. What do you say in these situations? Oi. Olá. Oi, tudo bem? Tudo bem, e você? Tchau. Até mais. Adeus. You now know lots of ways to greet people in Portuguese. Now it's time for Paloma's point. You often hear people saying tudo bom instead of tudo bem in Brazil. Bem means well and bom means good, but you usually use both in the same situations. Although tudo bem is more grammatically correct. Tchau, tchau!
Want to speak real Portuguese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at PortuguesePod101.com.
E aí, galera, beleza? Paloma here. Welcome to another Top Portuguese Words. Today's topic is 20 travel phrases you should know. Travel, viajar. Você pode me ver o mapa? Could you get me a map? Você pode me ver o mapa? Could you get me a map? Well, nowadays everyone has cell phone and we have maps on it, so it's not that useful anymore. But sometimes in some smaller cities, it's very useful to have a map. So just remember the word mapa. It's not that hard, right? Você fala inglês? Do you speak English? Você fala inglês? Do you speak English? Well, this is kind of a survival phrase, especially if you don't speak Portuguese very well. You should know that one. So you can, you know, just approach everyone and just ask them, você fala inglês? Você fala inglês? Well, if you speak another language, you can also ask, just change inglês for that language, right? Você fala inglês? Você fala francês? Você fala japonês? And hopefully someone will speak the language you need. Tem algum ônibus que vai do aeroporto até a cidade? Is there a bus from the airport to the city? Tem algum ônibus que vai do aeroporto até a cidade? Is there a bus from the airport to the city? In most airports, there will probably be a bus that goes from the airport to the city, so just ask information or guardinha, like a security guard. Yeah, we love to ask the guardinhas. Moço, excuse me, sir. Moço, com licença. Wi-Fi é gratuito? Is the Wi-Fi free? O Wi-Fi é gratuito? Is the Wi-Fi free? You can also say, o Wi-Fi é grátis? In most restaurants, hotels, and everywhere you go, they will have a Wi-Fi. So sometimes the Wi-Fi is free, but they still have a password. So you can ask, qual é a senha do Wi-Fi? What is the Wi-Fi password? Você tem quarto vago para hoje? Do you have any vacancies tonight? Você tem quarto vago para hoje? Do you have any vacancies tonight? I prefer to book for a room before going to the city, but many people prefer to just go to the place they want to go and there they find the hotel. Well, if you do that, then you have to ask, tem algum quarto para hoje à noite? Or tem algum quarto vago para hoje à noite? Eu poderia me mudar para outro quarto? Could I move to a different room? Eu poderia me mudar para outro quarto? Could I move to a different room? Well, there are many reasons why you want to change a room. Maybe it's too noisy, barulhento. Or something's broken, quebrado. So you can just go complain, this is broken, or it's too noisy. Posso me mudar para outro quarto? Eu tenho uma reserva. I have a reservation. Eu tenho uma reserva. I have a reservation. Well, you can use this at hotels or restaurants. If you want to be more specific, you can say, eu tenho uma reserva no nome de. I have a reservation under the name of. Eu tenho uma reserva no nome de Paloma. Você pode trazer o cardápio, por favor? Could you bring the menu, please? Você pode trazer o cardápio, por favor? Could you bring the menu, please? Okay, this is very useful because many countries, they also use the word menu, similar to the English. But in Brazil, we mostly use the word cardápio. So don't forget it. If you say menu, they probably understand, but it's much more common to say cardápio. Você tem alguma sugestão? Do you have any recommendations? Você tem alguma sugestão? Do you have any recommendations? So you can ask that to the waiter, the waitress, or maybe the tour guide. You can also say like, I like meat. Do you have any recommendations? Eu gosto de carne. Você tem alguma sugestão? Você pode trazer a conta? Could I have the check? Você pode trazer a conta? Can I have the check? So, você pode trazer a conta literally means, can you bring me the bill? But, well, in English it's more common to say, can I have the check, maybe? You can also say just, a conta, por favor, the check, please. Eu sou alérgico a amendoim. I'm allergic to peanuts. Eu sou alérgico a amendoim. I'm allergic to peanuts. I'm so lucky I'm not allergic to anything, so I can just order whatever I want. Maybe I won't like it, but at least it won't be bad for me. If you're allergic to something, make sure to know that word in Portuguese. If you don't know that word, you can just Post in the comments below and we'll make sure to answer you. Uma água, por favor. Water, please. Uma água, por favor. Water, please. Usually when you order water in Brazil, they come in bottles, they don't come in glasses. And they are usually água mineral, not água com gás, which would be sparkling water. So if you just want normal, natural water, you can just say água mineral. Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? So if you're in store looking at things, you can just say, oh, I like that one. Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? Eu quero 10 desses. I'd like 10 of this. Eu quero 10 desses. I'd like 10 of this. So if you went to the store and you asked, quanto custa este daqui? And you liked it, you can just say, eu vou levar 10 desses. I'm gonna take 10 of this. Eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. Eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. If you want to be very specific, you can say, eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. If you want that one, you would say, eu quero aquele dali. Tem desconto? Is there a discount? Tem desconto? Is there a discount? So it's very common to ask for discounts in Brazil. You can also say, tem desconto no dinheiro? Is there a discount in cash? Especially if you're buying a lot of merchandise, you can ask that. Of course, you're not gonna ask in a supermarket or a chain store, but if it's like a local business, it's more common to give a discount. Maybe in touristic areas, not that common, but well, you should try, right? As we say in Brazil, não custa nada. Doesn't cost anything. At the most, your answer is gonna be no, no, não tem desconto. Vocês aceitam cartão de crédito? Do you take credit card? Vocês aceitam cartão de crédito? Do you take credit card? Nowadays, you can pay by credit card everywhere. It's very, very hard to find a place that doesn't accept credit card. Like, it's crazy. Even if you go, for example, to the beach, there's like the guy selling earrings and he's gonna have his credit card machine so you can pay with credit card. I'm not kidding. Yeah. Onde fica a rodoviária? Where's the bus terminal? Onde fica a rodoviária? Where's the bus terminal? You can say rodoviária or terminal rodoviário, but it's much more common just to say rodoviária. Quanto é a passagem? What's the fare? Quanto é a passagem? What's the fare? You can use the question at the rodoviária, the bus terminal, for example, for a long distance bus, but you can also use it for a local bus. For example, if you don't see the price that is usually in the front of the bus, you can just ask the driver, motorista, or cobrador, você poderia parar em, or você poderia me avisar? But first you have to ask, quanto é a passagem? Quanto é a tarifa? Você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Could you take a picture of me, please? Você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Can you take a picture of me, please? Most people nowadays don't leave their home without their selfie stick, which in Portuguese is pau de selfie. But if you don't have your pau de selfie, you can just ask someone, você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Or, você pode tirar uma foto de nós, por favor? Can you take our picture, please? Yeah, I'm talking with my ghost friend here. The end! That's all for today. Thanks a lot for listening. I hope you enjoyed it. Let us know which other words or sentences you need to know before traveling to Brazil. See you next time. Tchau, tchau.
Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Hi, everybody. I'm Paloma. Welcome to PortuguesePod101.com's Português em 3 Minutos, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Portuguese. In the last lesson, we learned some words used when apologizing in Portuguese, including com licença and desculpa. In this lesson, we are going to learn numbers in Portuguese. Yes, numbers, os números, from 1 to 10. And you are going to learn them in only 3 minutes, 3 minutos. Are you ready? Let's start. 1, 1. 2, 2. 3, 3. 4, 4. 5, 5. 6, 6. 7, 7. 8, 8. 9, 9. 10, 10. Okay, now repeat after me. I'll say the numbers and give you time to repeat each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great job! What is before do you know? It's the same as in English, but with a different pronunciation. Zero. Zero. You don't have any more excuses. You can give your friends your cell phone number in Portuguese. Let's try together. We use the phrase o meu número é, which means my number is. O meu número é. O meu número é 978657 70. Can you read it by yourself? 978657 70. Perfect! Now it's time for Paloma's point. When you say your telephone number in Brazil, we sometimes use the word meia instead of the number 6. It means half and is an abbreviation of half a dozen, meia dúzia. Do you know the Portuguese word for 100? In the next lesson, we are going to learn the numbers from 11 to 100 in Portuguese. Your task now is to practice the numbers we studied in this lesson, from 1 to 10. Até a próxima!
Boa tarde, galera! Tudo bom? Paloma here. Welcome to another Top Portuguese Words. Today's theme is Top 10 Must Know Vocabulary for the Restaurant. 1. Garçom. Waiter. Garçom. Waiter. Queria fazer o pedido, mas o garçom tá demorando tanto. I'd like to order, but the waiter is taking so long to serve us. If it is a female, that would be garçonete. You can also use the words moço or moça to call their attentions. For example, o moço or garçom. Both are okay. Cardápio. Menu. Cardápio. Menu. Por favor, você pode me trazer o cardápio? Can you bring me the menu, please? You can say before that, moço, garçom, você pode trazer o cardápio, por favor? Prato feito, PF. Set meal. O que eu como hoje? Acho que vou pedir um PF que sai mais barato. What should I eat today? I think I'll order a set meal, since it's cheaper. Prato feito or set meal is very common in Brazil, especially, for example, in the restaurants near business or schools, which is like a set plate, so you can just eat quickly and go to your work or school. But it's used at restaurants. For example, if you go to McDonald's, we don't order a PF or prato feito. It's usually called combo. Pratos feitos usually have like rice, beans, kind of protein, usually beef, and a salad. It's all good, PF. Bem passado, well done. Bem passado, well done. Gostaria da carne bem passada, por favor. I'd like the steak well done, please. While the opposite of bem passada would be mal passada. So if you want it rare, you would say mal passada, por favor. Acompanhamentos, side dishes. Acompanhamentos, side dishes. Nossa, tem tanta opção de acompanhamentos que eu nem sei o que pedir. Well, there are so many side dishes options that I can't decide what to order. What is your favorite side dish? I like purê de batata, mashed potatoes, what else? Batata frita, of course, french fries, arroz à grega, which is like a Greek rice, which is a rice with a lot of vegetables. Yeah, it's also very good. Água, water. Água, water. Pode me trazer uma água com gás, por favor? Could you bring me a sparkling water, please? Okay, so just remember that if you say just água, they'll probably bring you normal water. And if you say água com gás, that would be sparkling water. Por quilo, by quilo. Por quilo, by quilo. Como eu como pouco, eu prefiro ir num restaurante por quilo. Since I don't eat much, I prefer to go to a per quilo restaurant. So per quilo restaurants are very common in Brazil. It's a kind of buffet, and you just go and grab whatever you wanna eat, and then you're gonna weight your plate. And whatever is the weight is gonna be how much you pay for it. So if you eat a lot, usually it's not a good deal, but if you eat very little, it's usually a good deal because it's not gonna pay for a full set menu if you don't eat everything. So you can just grab whatever you want. For example, if you're on a diet and you are hanging out with your friends and you're just gonna eat some salad, it's very good because you don't need to order, you know, a whole piece of meat and don't eat it. You can just grab your salad and weigh it and eat it. Restaurante por quilo. Another option would be restaurante self-service, which you pay a price and then you can just eat as much as you want at the buffet. Restaurante, restaurant. Restaurante, restaurant. Conheça um restaurante de comida italiana ótimo por aqui. Você vai adorar. I know a great Italian restaurant around here. You'll love it. So we have restaurantes, which are restaurants. We also have lanchonete, which are like a snack restaurant. And then we have like specific places, pizzeria, pizza restaurant, pastelaria, a restaurant that only serves pastel, churrascaria, which only serves churrasco or Brazilian barbecue. Delicioso, delicious, delicioso, delicious. Esse pudim tá delicioso. Acho que vou pedir mais um pedaço. This pudding is delicious. I think I'll order another one. Tá delicioso. Or can also say tá maravilhoso. It's marvelous. Conta, bill. Conta, bill. Pode trazer a conta, por favor? Can I have the bill, please? Or can you bring me the bill, please? Bill can be used at the restaurant bill, but you can also use it for other types of bills. For example, conta de luz, the electricity bill, conta de água, the water bill, conta de gas, maybe, gas bill. There's so many contas, so many bills. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And let us know in the comments, what is your favorite type of Brazilian restaurants? And don't forget to subscribe to PortuguesePod101.com and also to our YouTube channel.
Oi, gente! This is Jade Furuta and welcome to another Portuguese Weekly Words. So let's start. Today's theme is direction words. Direction reminds me of One Direction. Chamo One Direction! Beijo! Okay, let's go. Direita. Direita. That means right. Right. Direita. Por favor, vire à direita. Please turn right. Leste. East. Far East movement. What can I say? Fica ao leste. It's at the east side. Sul. South. Eu sou da América do Sul. I'm from South America. Fora. Fora. Outside. Deixe o cachorro lá fora. Leave the dog outside. Yeah, normally in Brazil we always keep the dogs, the pets, outside. And we also feed them normal food. And I remember trying to feed my dog food, poor thing. He got so stomach sick. Dentro. Inside. In Brazil, we cook a lot. We eat a lot of food. My family cooks for me and I eat all the time. Eu gosto de comer muito Quando estou dentro de casa, I like to eat a lot when I'm inside home. This is all. This was our Portuguese weekly words. I hope you're learning and I'm hoping you're having a good time with our classes. Bikis, beijo, tchau, tchau.
Oi, meu nome é Paloma. Hi everybody, I'm Paloma. Welcome to PortuguesePod101.com's Português em 3 Minutos, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Portuguese. In the last lesson, we learned how to count in Portuguese. I hope you spent some time practicing the numbers, because they will come in handy today. We are going to learn how to go shopping in Brazil. Before we go, you need to know how to say how much is it. Quanto custa? Quanto custa? Are you ready to go shopping in Brazil? Let's go! You see something you like and want to ask the shop clerk how much it costs. The first thing to say to a shop clerk is, com licença. Do you remember what that means? Excuse me. And then, while you point at something you want to buy, you can say, com licença, quanto custa? Com licença, quanto custa? If you want to be more specific when asking how much it is and refer to a certain type of object, we need to know if the object is feminine or masculine. If it's a masculine, add esse or essa for a feminine object, and then say the noun. For example, dress is masculine. Vestido. Com licença, quanto custa esse vestido? Excuse me, how much is this dress? Com licença, quanto custa esse vestido? And t-shirt is a feminine noun, camiseta. Com licença, quanto custa essa camiseta? Excuse me, how much is this t-shirt? Com licença, quanto custa essa camiseta? At this point, the shop clerk can answer by simply saying the number plus reais. For example, 37 reais. What number is 37? I'm not telling you. Okay, it's 37. It costs 37 reals. Now it's time for Paloma's point. In Brazil, it's very common to haggle when you're buying in small businesses. An easy way to ask for discount is to say, tem desconto? Is there any discount? Tem desconto? At this point, can you count reals in Portuguese? We are going to learn how to do this and much more in the next lesson. I'll be waiting for you in our next Português em 3 Minutos lesson. Até a próxima!
Bom dia, gente! Tudo bom? Paloma here! Welcome to Top 10 Ways to Prepare for Your Travel. To choose your destination. Escolher o seu destino de viagem. Escolher o seu destino de viagem. Choose your destination. A senhora já escolheu seu destino de viagem? Ma'am, did you choose your travel destination yet? So, destino de viagem is destino, destination, and viagem, travel. In a more casual situation, you wouldn't ask your travel destination. It's more common to say, você já decidiu para onde você vai? Did you already decide where you're going to? To buy a guidebook. Comprar um guia de viagem. Comprar um guia de viagem. To buy a guidebook. Vamos comigo à livraria? Preciso comprar um guia de viagem urgente. Let's go to the bookstore. I need to buy a guidebook urgently. It's always nice to have a guidebook with you when you go traveling because you have, you know, in one place all the destinations and places you should visit instead of searching on the internet. Maybe you don't have internet outside your hotel, so you need to be asking around. And if you have your guidebook, you can, you know, by yourself go around the city and you have your guide, your own guide. To save money. Economizar. To save money. Economizar. Economizar. Ah, tá tão difícil economizar dinheiro para viagem. Preciso me esforçar mais. Oh, it's been so hard to save money for this trip. I need to make an extra effort for it. So I have two interesting verbs in this sentence. economizar e esforçar-se. Economizar, to save money, and esforçar-se, to make an effort. So if you want to travel, you should make an effort to save money. Você precisa se esforçar para economizar. To book a flight. Comprar a passagem aérea. To book a flight. Comprar a passagem aérea. Comprar a passagem aérea. Vou comprar a passagem aérea pela internet. I'll book a flight online. This is the most common way to book flights nowadays. You just go on your computer or even on your cell phone and you book your flight instead of going to a travel agency, uma agência de viagens. You can just book online. Comprar online ou comprar pela internet. To request vacation time. Pedir férias. To request vacation time. Pedir férias. Pedir férias. Quero pedir férias em dezembro para viajar com toda a família. I want to request my vacations in December to travel with all the family. In Brazil, we have a whole month of vacations, so it's enough time to go and visit another place, even another country, or go visit your parents and spend a lot of time with your relatives. Yeah. To book a hotel. Reservar hotel. To book a hotel. Reservar hotel. Reservar hotel. Você já reservou hotel? Did you already book the hotel? It's very important to book a hotel, especially in high seasons, because if you just go there, you might not have availability in the hotel you want to go to. Yeah, so if you can, book your hotel before going to the city. To renew your passport. Renovar o seu passaporte. To renew your passport. Renovar o seu passaporte. Renovar o seu passaporte. Ah, meu passaporte está vencido. Preciso renovar o quanto antes. Oh, my passport is expired. I need to renew it ASAP. So, if you're traveling to another country, you need to make sure you have a passport and that this passport still has at least 6 months, I think, of availability of time before it expires. To pack. Fazer as malas. To pack. Fazer as malas. Fazer as malas. Você sempre demora muito para fazer as malas. You always take too long to pack. I love this part. Fazer as malas. What I don't like is the opposite. Desfazer as malas. To unpack. Oh, it's so boring. I just like to go traveling, not come back. To buy travel insurance. Contratar seguro de viagem. To buy travel insurance. Contratar seguro de viagem. É obrigatório contratar seguro de viagem internacional. It's mandatory to buy international travel insurance. It's always a good idea to have your insurance, just in case, you know, something happens. We hope it doesn't, but, well, it's better to be safe than sorry, right? To get a visa. Tirar o visto. To get a visa. Tirar o visto. Para viajar para este país, precisamos tirar o visto. We need to get a visa to travel to this country. Nowadays, you can just check on internet if you need a visa, if you're going to Brazil, or Portugal, or Angola, Mozambique, or any other country that speaks Portuguese. And be sure to go to the consulate ahead of time, so you have enough time to get your visa before you travel. É o fim, the end. All for today. Thanks a lot for watching, and let us know what is your favorite part of preparing for a trip. See you next time. Até mais. Tchau. Oi, tudo bom? Eu sou a Paloma. Welcome to Top Portuguese Words. Today's topic is going to be Top 10 Phrases to Survive at the Station. Eu quero ir para. I'd like to go to. Eu quero ir para. I'd like to go to. Eu quero ir para a Estação da Fé. Como faço? Eu quero ir para a Estação da Sé. Como faço? I'd like to go to Sé Station. What should I do? Ah, é só pegar o metrô nesta plataforma mesmo. Ah, é só pegar o metrô nesta plataforma mesmo. Oh, just get the subway on this platform. Sé is one of the biggest stations in São Paulo. It's where you can make a lot of baldeações, or changing subways. Esta é a plataforma para... Is this the right platform for... Esta é a plataforma para ir até o metrô Liberdade? Esta é a plataforma para ir até o metrô Liberdade? Is this the right platform for Liberdade Station? É sim, eu também vou para lá. É sim, eu também vou para lá. Yes, it is. I'm going there too. Liberdade used to be kind of the Japanese town in São Paulo, but nowadays we have a lot of Koreans and Chinese as well, so it's kind of the Asian neighborhood in São Paulo City. Onde faço a baldeação para? Where do I change for? Onde faço a baldeação para? Where do I change for? Onde faço a baldeação para a estação Jabaquara? Onde faço a baldeação para estação Jabaquara? Where do I change to Jabaquara Station? Ah, você tem que ir até a estação Sé. Ah, você tem que ir até a estação Sé. Oh, you have to go to Sé Station. Jabaquara is a very important subway station that is located in the Blue Line, linha azul. Onde fica o metrô? Where's the subway station? Onde fica o metrô? Where's the subway station? Onde fica o metrô Brigadeiro? Onde fica o metrô Brigadeiro? Where's the Brigadeiro subway station? É logo ali atravessando a rua. É logo ali atravessando a rua. It's right over there across the street. Brigadeiro is one of the subways located in Avenida Paulista, or Paulista Avenue, one of the most important avenues in São Paulo. Quanto custa para ir até... How much is it to... Quanto custa para ir até... How much is it to... Quanto custa para ir até a Estação da Luz? Quanto custa para ir até a Estação da Luz? How much is it to Luz Station? Ah, menos de 5 reais. Não é caro. Ah, menos de 5 reais. Não é caro. Oh, less than 5 reais. It's not expensive. In São Paulo, the subway ticket has a fixed price, so you can change as many trains as you need, and you will always pay the same. But you can also use this phrase to ask in a bus station or even to your taxi driver if you want to have a reference of how much it's going to cost. Este ônibus vai para... Does this bus go to... Este ônibus vai para... Does this bus go to... Este ônibus vai para o shopping SP Market? Este ônibus vai para o shopping SP Market? Does this bus go to shopping SP Market? Sim, pode subir. Sim, pode subir. Yes, come on up. If you're looking for a mall in Brazil, you're looking for a shopping. Not that hard, right? So you can go shopping at the shopping. Onde é o ponto de ônibus? Where's the bus stop? Onde é o ponto de ônibus? Where's the bus stop? Onde é o ponto de ônibus? Onde é o ponto de ônibus? Where's the bus stop? Ah, no final da rua, perto da padaria. Ah, no final da rua, perto da padaria. Oh, at the end of the street, near the bakery. It's very common in Brazil to use shops as reference for given locations. For example, na padaria, the bakery, or supermercado, supermarket, loja de sapatos, shoe store, floricultura, loja de flores, and so on. Que horas vem o próximo ônibus? What time is the next bus? Que horas vem o próximo ônibus? Que horas vem o próximo ônibus? What time is the next bus? Daqui uns 10 minutos. Daqui uns 10 minutos. In about 10 minutes.
Due to the traffic in most cities in Brazil, it's very hard to give an exact time for the next bus, but people waiting at the bus stop may know around how many minutes it's going to take for the next bus. O ônibus está atrasado. The bus is running late. O ônibus está atrasado. Será que demora? O ônibus está atrasado. Será que demora? The bus is running late. Will it take too long to arrive? Ah, no final de semana demora mesmo. Ah, no final de semana demora mesmo. Oh, on weekends it usually takes longer to get there. Onde tem máquina de recarga de bilhete? Where are the ticket recharge machines? Onde tem máquina de recarga de bilhete? Onde tem máquina de recarga de bilhete? Where are the ticket recharge machines? Logo ali. Logo ali. Over there. So in São Paulo you can buy a card called Bilhete Único, and it's actually cheaper than buying one ticket. So if you're staying a long time in São Paulo, you might consider that option. There's also for Rio and other cities that have subway in Brazil. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to check our website, PortuguesePod101.com, and give us your like. Até a próxima. Tchau, tchau.